first fighter to the blue corner, Soraya Mucheri.
Your people! Original Batman Cell!
Christy Brereton.
Even though the dancing's done, no worry, 'cause the night is young.
At 55 kilograms. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the pink, yellow, and black. She brings with her into the ring an impressive record of 55 wins, opposite just 5 defeats. Fighting out of France, here is Soraya Mucheri! And her opponent, fighting out of the red corner, wearing the pink and orange. She brings with her into the ring a record of 14 wins, 4 defeats, and 1 draw. Fighting out of Chaos Gym in England, make some noise for Christy Brereton! And when the action begins, your referee in charge is Sean Boland.
She had a bit of time off. Quality fighter, but she's up against a girl with pretty much 4 times the amount of wins over her in Soraya Mucheri from France in the blue corner. So I've never seen her fight, but her record is outstanding, like 54 wins, 5 losses.
Yeah, very strong, Soraya Mucheri. She's
this will be has the makings of a great fight. 55 kilos, A class. So 5 3-minute rounds. Christy holds wins over some top names in this country, though.
She does, yeah. She's really cemented herself on. It'd be interesting to see how she comes back.
Very measured there, Soraya.
She's been in there a lot of times, hasn't she?
Yep, best part of 60 fights. Not bad.
good hands from Berrington.
Some solid body kicks coming in there from French corner.
Push kick found its way lightly to the face there of Bouchery. Christy Berrington closing down this ring. Yeah. Wanting to get on with the action early, isn't she?
It's going to see what they're like in the clinch. Already Christy pulling the head down well.
Yeah, got the dominant position there, didn't she?
Blue corner got her way out of that one. Again, it's still the feeling out stage. Again, another push kick to the face there. But you see the difference in the knees from these girls. The point of the knee goes right into the body.
Some of the best elbow knees we've seen all evening, Dave, and they're coming from the ladies here. Nice evasion from Brereton, and then responds with a high kick. Yeah, Bouchery is starting slowly, and you will watch her grow in this fight, I guarantee you that.
Yeah, both these girls are quality to watch.
Noticeable reddening on the lead leg of Christy Brereton early here.
Nice little block there with the leg from Bouchery.
Just showing a bit of experience there. They're both exchanging some really lethal knees to each other's abdomen.
Christy just going around the outside of that block to pop a knee back. Both girls' legs are getting a little bit reddening on there.
Yep.
On the lead leg.
Yep, inside Bouchery's lead leg and the outside of Brereton's lead leg.
Yeah, very even at this stage.
Getting bored of saying it now, Dave. Another very good matchup here.
Yeah, really good.
Just one of those nights where you think that every fight could go the distance and down to the judges' scorecards. Great to have all these international bouts on these fight cards here. Super MTC, representatives from Italy and France here tonight. Titles flying across the channel and across Europe. This really is what the crowd come to see. A testament to Muay Thai here in England.
I thought it was David Chu in the French corner there for a second.
Yeah, very calm, collected French corner over there. She hasn't thrown too much in early. Do notice French fighters do fight very similar to Thais. Have you noticed that? They all start slowly and then get their work done in the third to fourth to fifth round.
We've got some of the best Thai boxers in the world are French.
Really have, yeah.
Some good quality.
And regularly fighting on the UK shores. Only a couple of weeks ago, I was commentating on Mohamed Bukhareb fighting Liam Harrison. Not fighting Andy Housen, rather. And Mehdi's a two fighting Liam Harrison. Now the girls are travelling over to commence battle
set
again.
Out.
Almost like Napoleon round days, two. Dave.
Yeah, round two. Let's see if we've got rid of the first round nerves. French corner looking out, looking to come out and mean business. Okay, nice little block back from Christy.
Turning her hip into those knees extremely well, Brereton. The better clinch work is coming from the English girl.
French girl going in with the hands first to just bring the guard up for play, placing her kick in.
Yeah.
Trying to beat Poppy.
Well, mesmerised by these girls, putting on a really good display. Brereton pulling the head down of the French girl.
This
trying
to
knee up to the head, yep. She needs to watch out, this French girl. Soraya Boucherie has lightning hands. Brereton needs to keep her head back to stick with those knees because they look absolutely lethal, don't they?
Can't help but feel that Christie's warming into this fight a bit quicker than Blue Corner.
Yeah, I think so.
She seems to be changing pace and finding her distance and picking her shots a bit better. Blue Corner, I don't feel, has stepped up as much into this round.
All setting up for a very explosive end to this bout, I can imagine. Elbows from Berrington, she's looking for them already.
Good strong knees going up the middle there for a good score.
Really impressed with the knees here, Dave. They're the best knees we've seen all night, I think. Both girls wearing them really well as well.
Push kick to the face there again, landing flush on the French woman's face.
Looks very strong in the clinch, Brereton. All the French girl wants to do is disturb that clinch now and get out of it. Have you noticed that?
Yeah.
Brereton's doing an act on her now.
I do feel like she's coming into herself more in this round.
Yeah, really, really good representation here. Buried that low kick there, Dave.
Yeah, Brereton throws her shots really hard there. She's got tagged on the way in there, but nothing is going to affect her.
Good round for Brereton.
Yeah, much stronger there. It'll be interesting to see how the third round picks up, if the French woman can step into the next gear. I think she needs to, because Christy seemed to edge that one ahead there. For me, anyway.
Yeah, totally agree with you, Dave. But watching French fighters for a long time, as we all have, but I know they work their way into fights and fight strong at the end, real tight style. We are approaching round three, and I think Soraya Boucherie needs to lay her name down on this round, actually, because Christy Berrington seems to be up in the gears, up in the pace, up in her products in this fight.
Yeah, I think she needs to step it up to keep in there with Christy, really. And if Christy, again, moves it to the next gear in this round, then I could see her running away with this fight. But it's early days. Let's see what happens.
Of course, later on from France, Elias Buzaruta, and she is fighting. He is fighting, sorry, with Ash Udin. And also Andrea Cassiloni fighting Jose Varela. International bouts all over this show here tonight. I'm battling with the names in the commentary box here.
Never easy. But I'll stick with Ryan Ward and Sam Goff.
Second out.
Here we go. This will be the telltale of the match, I think.
I think so, yeah, Dave. We need a big round from the French girl here. She needs to really nail her name down in this round.
Yeah, well, she needs to stop Christy from finding her feet so well. I think if Christy carries on the way she's going, then she could edge this fight ahead again.
Ooh, faking the push kick and spearing the elbow in. Knees for me are definitely getting told by the English girl, Christy Berrington.
Yeah, you've even seen the kick in there. Blue Corner looks a bit more tired. Her kick is a bit weighted. And Christy sharply kicks back strongly. The French girl doesn't seem to have the same sort of sting she started out with, but I really thought she was going to step into it a bit more.
She's experienced. She's been here a lot of times.
Yeah.
I expect to.
I would say though,
Seymour.
Christy Barrington is talented beyond her numbers, though.
Really is. Oh, and knees the back. That is pure dominance and a big, big score.
Yeah, I always like that move. Work your way around the back, knee the back, show, like you say, showing dominance. Let the referee stop you. Perfectly legal. Great, great technique. But again, I don't know if it's the French woman's a bit tired, but she just seems to be.
I'm sure wearing Christy Berrington's knees in her midriff for the whole of this fight would have taken a lot out of her. So I think the low work rate of her is just pure confusion at trying to come forward.
Christy just riding this out a bit.
She's intelligent, isn't she? She doesn't waste energy where not necessary.
Nice kick back there from Christy, and a massive push kick to the face.
Right on top of the commentary box there.
Just rocking the head back of the French woman.
Strong though, isn't she?
Yeah, she's tough. She
wore that
back.
Well. I think that hurt me, when it hurt.
Christy going in with that left elbow. Big left elbows up the middle, two of them.
She's really, really going to work now, Barrington.
Lovely technique there, catching the kick and stepping in with a knee in it. Again, we're getting the pleasure of the elbows flying right above our head. Lovely blocking kick back there from Barrington.
Running away with this now, isn't she, Dave?
Yeah, she's outscoring nicely.
Massive round for the girl from England, Christy Barrington.
Yeah, really big round.
And a lot of work for Soraya Bouchery to do to come back into this fight. But we go into the money round, round four. Her corner team know she has a job to do now.
You can always see it. Look at the faces on both fighters, and the face in the blue corner looks a little bit despondent for me. Maybe that's just how it is, but...
Well, we've only done three rounds, Dave, but Christy Barrington can only lose this fight now, can't she? She's got to be ahead now.
Yeah, she's stepping ahead with it, but also you can see in her attitude, she looks like she knows that she's finding her feet, she's very comfortable in there, she knows what she's got to do, and now she's starting to put it all together nicely. It's just a good performance so far.
Firing up an instruction to the blue corner as France try and stamp their place on the British map here today in Camden Town, London. A big, big task ahead against the very talented Christy Barrington. Dave Fenton, what is the answer? If I put a French shirt on you right now and put you in that corner, what the hell would you say to Soraya Bouchery?
Yeah, it's difficult. She's missing out on every angle at the moment. For me, Christy's doing better at blocking and countering like that. Then on the inside, Christy's working better with the elbows and the knees. And from every angle, really, for me, Barrington is running away with it.
She's a lot more effective, isn't she? And a little bit sharper every time.
You just see it in the body language, even. Christy's switching on. She knows. Oh, lovely little right hook, left knee there. Stepping forwards.
Great technique. And skips off to the centre of the ring as well.
A lot of time you can win these fights or lose these fights in your head. And for me, the French woman is getting kicked across the back there. She knows she's in a fight.
You can tell from the body language, can't you?
She She's waiting too much. She's given Christy time, and Christy waits and then counters and hits. Or she's first. Either way, it's all red corner for me so far.
Most definitely, Dave. I can't argue with that at all.
Nice little skip back before she throws her left knee from Christy.
Works well off her left elbow and her left knee, Christy, yep. Looks in good nick though, doesn't she, the French girl? Doesn't look too damaged from this onslaught.
No, I thought she's strong. I just thought she seemed a little bit laboured in her shots. So didn't feel either that's nerves or fitness or what, no disrespect, but felt like Christy's sharper with all her shots.
Yeah, most definitely, Dave. Always just a little bit sharper, a little bit more effective more than anything. I said it before, some of the best knees we've seen tonight. They're really, really big intent and big scores. They're very effective every time.
Yeah, two quality girls going head to head here. Whoa, that left elbow just being out of range that second time.
Oh, but she's got her back there.
Yep, took a knee, but I think she was trying to set up her own spinning elbow, which just missed the mark.
Yep, she got outscored on that occasion, Dave. Just seems to me Soraya Boucheri just trying to get to the end of this fight now.
Yeah, work rate all seems to be coming from Christy at the moment.
She's spoiling the clinch every time now so that she doesn't wear damage from those knees.
I like Christy's little skip back before she knees to really plant it in.
She does it as well. She pulls her hip back so far and lands the spike of her knee every single time. 100% hit rate. This is an awesome fight for Christy Brereton.
I've got to say, that's probably a lot of what is slowing down the lady in the blue corner, because you cannot eat them for four rounds and not feel it.
I totally, totally agree with you, Mr. Fenson. It has taken the wind out of the young girl from France. And we approach the business end of the fight, the fifth, the final round. Soraya Boucheri needs a knockout, doesn't she?
Yeah, I'd say this is all red corner so far. And Christy just looking stronger throughout the fight, as Blue just doesn't really have an answer for it. We got some great bouts coming up as well. Ryan Ward versus Michael Pham, next fight, that's going to be immense.
It really is, yep. More international bouncers again. We've got another French fighter who fight an old friend of mine, Ash Udin, here. Also, it's Italy come head to head with England via Portugal, Jose Varela. Super MTC Team Shoe Show here in the Coco Club, Camden, London. This is the fifth and final round coming up between Soraya Boucheri from France in the blue corner and Christy Brereton from England over here in the red corner. Last bit of counselling in the French corner for this damage she's taken, I think, but also motivation. She needs a knockout on my card, but my card counts for nothing, of course. We go down to the officials here.
Never writing them off. I mean, this girl's had nearly 60 fights. If it goes the same way, Christy's walking away with this easy. But we're in the last round. Let's see if she's got what it takes. She looks tough. If she can throw strong, who knows?
Christy's merciless as well, though, isn't she? She wants to elbow all the time.
French girl's a bit more on her toes than I've seen her in the last round. Look. Sometimes that last ditch attempt can be quite powerful. But Christy just coming straight back with everything that she's headed with.
French girl looks like more of a K1 fighter to me, Dave. She doesn't look comfortable on the inside. She punches and kicks strong and then tries to knee. Just the distance she's got. Yeah. Just think tie rules are suiting Christy Brereton far more
Christie's.
Although K1's not big in France like Muay Thai.
Christie's got a nice style, I've always thought that.
Yep.
And you can see when she's using the little techniques like pushing her hands in the face, the French woman looks a little bit lost. And sometimes in the clinch, it's just about putting them in a position where they're not comfortable. And that's where Christie's punishing her then with the knees.
Both girls in good condition. There's been elbows flying around. Knees have been finding their way up high, but both girls look pretty unmarked, don't they? Good defence from both counts.
True. As we go into the last few stages of this fight, Christie just pushing the head back of the French woman.
She's tough, isn't she?
Yeah.
Really tough.
Both two tough girls, man.
Christy trying to elbow the back of the head and knee the face at the same time, almost there.
She's going for the kill right to the end. Again, as she steps into centre stage. Good head kick there.
Nice movement.
Lovely evasion, yeah.
Lovely evasion, movement, strikes as she goes.
Stepping in there. With that elbow up the middle, just not quite reaching the mark. Again, back into the clinch where Christie's been so strong in this fight. Hands in the face.
French girl just trying to spoil the clinch. I think she'd be happy to hear the end bell to this fight, don't you?
Yeah. She's not going in for the kill. She does need a knockout to win, but I think she's all out of answers, really. Christie Barrington just covering all bases really well. A good solid performance. Great matchup, though.
Yeah, very good match. She's found a very tough opponent ahead of her here. It's very hard to stop. She looks after herself, and I'll tell you what, she doesn't look bad for the damage she seems to have taken.
Yeah, she's eating some big knees through this fight.
Again, spoiling that clinch. That will go down as a comfortable win, I should imagine, for Christie Barrington.
Great fight, though. Great fight.
Really good fight, yep.
Great win to Team Chaos, red corner, Christie Barrington.
Another international bout, done and dusted here, Super MTC.
Fighting out of the red corner, Christie Barrington.